In this video, we are going to consider parallel lines and transversal and angles made by the transversal with two parallel lines. And what are the angles and what are their relations which the transversal makes with the two parallel lines, we are going to discuss here. Now you can see properties of angles made by transversal associated with parallel lines. Now two parallel lines AB and CD are cut by a transversal PQ at points R and S respectively, because there are two parallel lines and a transversal cut these two parallel lines at two points, namely R and S. We can show this in a following figure. Here CD and AB are parallel lines and PQ is a transversal which cuts AB at the point R and cuts CD at the point S. Now we can see here, we can label the angles. Let us denote the angles CSQ equal to 1 and DSQ is equal to 2, DSR equal to 3, and this CSR is equal to Q atwa RCS RSC is equal to 4, etc. Like this, we can label the angles of two parallel lines made by a transversal. Now we can see, now we are ready to deal with these angles. Angles 1, 2, 3, 4 and angles 5, 6, 7, 8. And now we can see corresponding angles. What are the corresponding angles? Four pair of angles, namely 2 and 6 and 3 and 7 and 1 and 5 and 4 and 8. 4 and 8 are called corresponding angles. Further note that angle 2 is equal to angle S, sorry, angle 6. Angle 2 equal to angle 6 and angle 3 is equal to angle 7, etc. And you can prove these properties, and corresponding angles are equal. You can prove it. You can see, prove it. I will leave it as an exercise here, and alternate angles, a pair of angles 4 and 6, 3 and 5 are called interior alternate angles. 4 and 5 and 3 and 6 are called interior alternate angles. Similarly, we can see B, a pair of angles 1 and 7 and 2 and 8 are called exterior angles. These two can still one more property which you can deal with. Further, these alternate angles are equal, interior or exterior they may be, but the alternate angles are always equal. You prove it this also. Next, we are going to consider interior angles on the same side of a transversal or supplementary angles. I mean, angle 3 plus angle 6 equal to 180 degree, and angle 4 and plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degree. That is, let us look at the figure here. Angle 4 and 5 are angles on the interior angles on the same side, PQ, of the transversal. 3 and 6 are also interior angles on the same side of the PQ, transversal PQ here. And now you can see, if we know one angle, then among 8 angles made by the transversal with the properties, we can easily determine the rest of the 7 angles. For example, here, now let us consider angle 1 is equal to X, and here you can see, you can write down, you can see here, two parallel lines, which you can write down, and this is two parallel lines, two parallel lines, a transversal which I can write down. If I note down this angle 1 equal to X naught, angle 1 is equal to X naught, then this is an angle, supplementary angle, that is 180 minus X naught. And these are vertically opposite angles, therefore this is also X naught, and this is 180 minus X naught, 180 and X degree. And now here, this plus this equal to X naught, because these are going to be interior alternate angles. And these are supplementary angles. These are that plus this is equal to, on the same side, that is 180. And this is vertically opposite angle. And this is 180 minus x degree. And therefore, this is also 180 minus x naught. Therefore, if you have one angle, or if you know one angle among 8, the rest of the 7 angles can be obtained by the properties of the angles associated with the parallel lines and associated with the transversal made by transversal with the parallel lines. And thus, we can get all the 7 angles.